everyone, it's Axel from SEGGER, and today I want to talk to you about how to do animations with emWin and AppWizard. The animation engine in AppWizard is pretty complex, and you can pretty much animate anything and everything in your GUI. And as an example, I'd like to use this analog GUI that's also part of the examples that come with AppWizard, so you can open it up and try that out at any time. By the way, we do have this unit control, unit status GUI in two other versions as well. One is a more futuristic version, and the other one is a more minimalistic version, just FYI. So this GUI contains animations, as you can see when you do the play mode. If you just leave it alone, you will see that first one of the switches is being switched, and then the rotary turns, the second switch goes down, rotary turns some more, third switch, fourth switch, and so on and so forth. So that is part of the animation that was defined in AppWizard, and that is controlling the GUI at this point. So let me show you how this is done. You can come down here to our handy shortcut buttons, and you click the one that says animations. And here you see all the animations that are part of your AppWizard project. In this case, it's just one single animation that we saw just a second ago. Obviously, I can add as many more animations as I would like to my project, or you can edit an existing animation, which is what I want to do. So I click edit. And here you have all the parameters and properties of this particular animation. So let's go through them. First, this is the name of the animation that you can change. This is the period. How long is this animation supposed to last in milliseconds? So in this case, it's going to last 20 seconds. We want this particular animation to auto start as soon as it's created. I'm going to talk about that in a little bit. And it's not going to be endless. We're just going to do one loop of this, but you can have multiple loops, or if you want this animation to go on forever, you just click endless. And then here you have the list of all the items that are part of your animation. So this column has all the items to be animated. And as we saw, first the switch gets animated, then the rotary, then the switch gets turned off. Then the next switch gets turned on, the rotary, that switch gets turned off, and so on and so forth. And here in the beginning of the table, you have the percentage of the start time and the end time of the animation relative to the duration of the entire animation. And then what the start value and the end value is of the item that's to be animated. So let's pick the animation item where the rotary gets changed from 150 to 200. And then let's look at the more detailed definition of this sub animation down here. So this turning of the rotary is happening from second 14 to second 15 in the overall 20 second animation, or in percentages, it's 70 to 75%. The item to be animated is an object value. You can also, in addition to object values, animate variables, object coordinates, or screen coordinates. This object is in screen 00, and the item to be animated is our unit control rotary. And we want to animate it from a value of 150 to a value of 200. And the ease of the animation should be such that it's first accelerated and then decelerated. You also have the option of just doing linear animation, or just accelerating fashion or decelerating fashion. Those are the other options you have. And by defining and adding all these items one by one to your animation, you end up with your complete animation. And here in the end, we actually see at the very end of the animation at 100%, a variable is set from 0 to 1. That is the ID variable done. And that actually causes a screen transition to the second screen. So as you can see, this is pretty convenient and pretty powerful. So you can create very, very complex animations in your GUI. So let's just cancel out of this and let me show you how the animation is created, started, and stopped with the interactions. So we see an interaction here that says whenever this screen has its initial dialogue, which is in the very beginning when the screen gets created, then also an animation is created, and we can look up which one that is. And it is the one we've just been looking at, because there's really only one in this project at this point. And because we set up our animation to auto start, as soon as it's created, it will also start running at this particular point. If you don't have an auto start, then you need an interaction where you use the job animation start to actually start the animation. And here's another interaction that says whenever anything gets pressed on the screen, the animation automatically stops because the user actually started interacting with the GUI. And here's that interaction at the very end of the animation where that variable is changed, and that causes a shift screen to the second screen over here. I hope you enjoyed this introduction on how to do animations in AppWizard. Please make sure to watch part 2, where we will actually create a new animation from scratch. Thanks for watching.